Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. Here's what you need to know as we begin this Thursday, January 28th. Following our exclusive report that the well-connected, wealthy donors and relatives of executives at Hunterdon Medical Center were able to jump the line over priority individuals and get a COVID vaccine, Governor Murphy is issuing a stern warning. He says if the report proves to be true, that it is incredibly offensive, and warns all hospitals and vaccination sites they better be following his state guidance from his health department. A Hunterdon Medical Center spokesman says some executives, board members, donors, and other volunteers were given shots only when the vaccine was in danger of expiring. You can read Aaron Vogt's exclusive report on the link beneath this video and at nj1015.com. Are you planning to get vaccinated? Surveys by the state health department showed as recently as last December, more than half of New Jersey residents were wary, and a good percentage of those said they would not be getting inoculated. That number has completely flipped, and this morning, more than 70% of residents in New Jersey say they are going to line up and get inoculated. The number of people being vaccinated in New Jersey is slowly starting to increase, but it's largely dependent on vaccine supply. That could be increased by as much as 30,000 doses a week. That's under President Biden's plan to increase the number of doses that are being delivered to individual states. Johnson & Johnson, meanwhile, says they're ready to present their phase 3 clinical trial information on their vaccine candidate as early as early next week. That would likely result in FDA approval shortly thereafter, and another 100 million doses of vaccine available nationwide in a matter of weeks or a couple of months. A couple of weeks ago, when officials announced that anybody 65 or older and other high-risk categories were eligible for a vaccination, they said you could basically go to any county vaccination site. State health officials are clarifying that a little bit now, saying those county sites are permitted to give priority to people who live, work, or study in the counties and then turn away individuals that do not fall into those categories. Health officials are confirming the presence of the UK variant in New Jersey. 8 cases now, including one person who has died, though the health commissioner says that individual did have underlying medical conditions. So far, there have been no confirmed cases of either the variant that originated in Brazil or South Africa. All of these variants may be more easily transmitted, but they do not appear to cause more severe symptoms. As the largest teachers' union in the state continues to push for teachers to be priority members on that vaccination list, Governor Murphy says he is on board. He'll have additional guidance in the coming days. In Middlesex Borough, kids remain on a remote schedule after the teachers' union refused to allow educators back into classrooms until they were vaccinated. A similar dispute in Montclair, not necessarily over vaccinations, but over safety in classrooms, could end up in court as talks between the teachers' union and the school district have now broken down. New Jersey's congressional delegation is hoping that now Democrats control the Senate, the House, and the White House, that they'll finally be able to get the limit on local and property tax deductions lifted. It's the so-called salt cap. $10,000 was the number that it was capped at in 2017, and that has remained. If successful, New Jersey Congressman Josh Gottheimer says it would bring a measure of tax relief to New Jersey residents and residents of other high-tax states. The numbers from the Port Authority really are telling the tale of the pandemic. Looking at the decline in the number of air passenger volume, that is almost 75%, nearly 80% decline in ridership on path. Bridge and tunnel traffic is off 19%, but as we were forced into isolation and many of us staying home during the pandemic, we were buying more stuff online, and that is reflected in a 21% increase in cargo delivery to New Jersey seaports. Governor Murphy has ordered an independent investigation of the Corrections Department after reports surfaced of inmate beatings at the state's only women's prison. But Murphy is rejecting calls to remove, even temporarily, Corrections Commissioner Marcus Hicks, even though a growing number of bipartisan lawmakers have called for Hicks to step aside until that investigation is completed. Got something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls and talking Jersey on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's what you need to know to start this Thursday, January 28th. Have a great day.